What's going on, you guys? Welcome back. Last video, we installed brand new valve springs in the Turbo Mustang to try and fix my RPM issue. Now, we pulled out the original springs, we pulled the springs out, tested them on our vise over there against our brand new springs, and found that the ones that were in the car were extremely weak, especially if you go back further on the channel to watch the original video of rebuilding those heads. Those springs got extremely weaker than they were when we first put them in. So that obviously was creating some kind of issue. So I'm hoping our new springs fix that. And I am definitely looking forward to getting this thing back on the track, seeing if I can get my goal of getting somewhere in the tens. So that is definitely coming up. But today we are working on the Manco Dingo, the silver bullet. And you can see there we have got a Duramax 18 horse 440 engine. Now that engine's been sitting underneath my little workbench now for the last couple years. And the only reason I have that engine is because it was originally bought for Frankenstein. Now, of course, Frankenstein, the scale of it was much smaller when I bought that engine, but because buddy of mine hit me up and gave me the Gixxer engine, I had to kind of adapt it to that, build on it, make it bigger, which might make it seem why some of the things on that buggy are a little out of proportions, because I had already bought it and I've just been running with it, and I will upgrade all that stuff when the time comes. But for right now, we're gonna run what I got, burn it up, just have fun. So anyways, enough of that. Back on the Manco Dingo here. Now, Seth is in school, and the last thing we did to this thing here is we did a bunch of upgrades to a bone stock Predator 212, did everything you weren't supposed to do, and it did exactly what it should have done, which was blow up. He sent the rod through the top of the block, and I think the only reason it didn't go any farther is because the gas tank was still there. So we pulled the engine. Right, the video, we pulled that engine apart, showed you what happened. And this poor little go-kart has actually been sitting over here next to the trees. But anyways, gonna surprise Seth, pulled the engine out from underneath that bench. I have got this really heavy duty engine plate, and I kind of just set it up there. As you can see, I got the engine sitting in place, kind of. And I'm just going back and forth, try to figure out the best placement for this. You can see I got little black lines on the frame there, and those are just reference points to where I want to put that plate. I got our centrifugal clutch kind of sitting up there in place. So as you can see, I have got to move our sprocket over, which should be no big deal. I have enough room. So this little go-kart should be a whole lot of fun, going from a little 6-horse engine to an 18 horsepower engine. Now, I'm not gonna do anything crazy to the engine just yet. We're gonna keep this thing bone stock just so he can ride around and have some fun with it. I will be removing the governor and all that other neat stuff in upcoming videos. But for right now, my plan today is get the original engine plate cut off that frame, mock up this new engine plate here, get this engine set up in place. And I want to try to do that before he gets home, kind of surprise him a little bit. Right, I want to see the smile on his face. So go ahead and get set up here, pull all that engine off, and start cutting. Engine's been removed, everything's been cut off, and I also went ahead, measured out, and made some new supports for our frame. Here's what we got going on right now. So there's our new engine. I got it sitting up on our new engine plate, went ahead and put on our centrifugal clutch, got our chain somewhat attached. Now these bolts are just hand tight to help me center everything up. And if you look down in there, everything still has to be welded. It is just sitting on itself right now to help me get everything centered up and make sure I have enough room for adjustment on everything. Now, I have the engine plate actually a little bit farther back, and that is to make sure I have a lot of room for adjustment. As a matter of fact, these bolts are pretty much sitting center. Well, a little bit shy of center, but I do have plenty of room adjustment forward and back, which will give me a little bit of room if I ever remove the fuel tank or put a longer chain with a different sprocket setup, perhaps a torque converter setup in the future. I'm not 100% sure. And it'll give me something to kind of build off of, maybe make a little bumper or a wheelie bar of some sort, because there is actually a lot of weight back there just past the center of that axle. So this thing is, or may be, a lot of fun in the grass. So now that I've got pretty much everything mocked up where I want it, I'll go ahead, pull the engine off, get our supports welded to the frame, get our engine plate welded up as well, get that engine reattached, hook up the throttle, get it up on stands, fire it up, because this engine's never ran. I've had it for a couple years now and never started it, so. Fingers crossed. It turns over fine. Gotta add oil, because there is no oil in it, so. But anyways, get everything set up, get this engine off, and start welding up our frame. Engine is all mounted up, clutch, chain are on, we got oil in it, we got fuel in it, and just in time, because Seth just got home from school. Delilah is also up here hanging out. As you guys can see there, we have it sitting up on jack stands. Here's our chain. Now I still need to get the bolt for the end of the crankshaft here, but I do have these set screws installed with Loctite, and they are pretty tight. Also went ahead and hooked up our throttle cable, so hopefully that works out. Now, like I said, I've had this engine for a couple years. It has been sitting underneath that bench over there, so this is the first time it has had fuel and oil in it. Hopefully it starts. I did, however, check for spark, because I have this guy here undone. I didn't know if I had to have that hooked up in order for it to run, but apparently it is just the key for the electrical start. And it does have a kill switch on there, so for me to stop this right now, I'm going to have to pull the spark plug wire. And all I did was pull the wire, put in this plug, just kind of pull it over, make sure it had spark, and it does. So now I'm going to get you in the stand. Go ahead and turn the fuel on. This guy keeps running away from the camera. I'll put you in the stand, turn the fuel on, turn the choke on, pull it over a couple times, and fingers crossed. All right, got you in the stand. See, there's the exhaust, so you believe me. First time, turn the fuel on. Choke is on, I think. Go ahead and pull it over. Fingers crossed, hopefully everything goes good. This is a big engine on a little cart. Maybe this is the choke. Put
I don't know, man. It doesn't say. It just says... There, maybe that one. Oh! Turn up the idle. Yeah. Heck yeah.
That's pretty good.
So this is choke on. Wow. I think that thing's gonna be fun. That was cool, pretty quick. I know which way the choke is now. It's actually really, really cool. First time I've heard this thing run. It's neat how quiet it is versus the 212 we had before this guy blew it up. But we are gonna do a bunch of neat upgrades to this too. I am gonna get a billet rod for this. I pulled the governor out, bigger springs, all that neat stuff. But cool thing is this engine has way more horsepower than the other one, and this was completely bone stock. So go ahead and let this run for a couple minutes. We'll get Seth to get a helmet on, or I'll get a helmet on first. I'll be the crash test dummy. Go around the yard real quick, make sure everything kind of works, and then we'll turn him loose on it. All right, out of the shop. It's been running a couple minutes now. So this will be the first test ride. Seth's got the helmet for me. I'm going to have him record because I'm going to put it on just because. So, thank you.
Hey, can you make sure there's no spiders in this?
Yeah. Yeah. that poor little guy is on fire. So I don't know, I must have the wrong clutch for it or something. So that is something I am going to look into. Throw some air on it, hopefully cool it down. All right, be back in a sec.
All right, so we let this thing cool down, went ahead and took the clutch off the side here, and we actually found a major issue. And when I say we, I mean Seth. He's the one that pointed it out. You guys could tell on the video there, it didn't sound like the clutch was engaging like it should. Part of the problem would probably be the gear ratio. I didn't realize how many teeth are on that clutch right there versus our clutch on the axle, and our ratio is definitely a little off, right? It should probably be fine hauling the little guys around, but me, not so much. Two, what had happened is, now I had already swapped the linkage around, but all this was on the bottom, and when we went to hit the throttle, the pedal was hitting our tie rod here, not allowing us to get full throttle, which was letting the clutch is inside that clutch there kind of swing out just enough to rub, but not enough to really fully engage. And what we ended up doing was smoking the spring and everything. It was starting to just lock itself up. But I was able to rebuild that clutch using another clutch here. And if you have never pulled one apart, I'm gonna show you here real quick. So when you order these things, now this is for a 212, but all the internals are the same as the clutch that are on that engine. But anyways, get your snap ring pliers. You pull this outer clip off right here, which will allow the shell to come off. We'll go ahead and put that to the side. Underneath the shell, you have this guard right here. This also helps hold the clutches in place. You're gonna pull another snap ring off, which will allow you to pull this guard off and expose the clutches. Now, these are the clutches that came out of the one that were on the engine. And you can see here, I'll point it out to you, where it heated up because it wasn't fully engaging and let the spring stretch, allowing all these little clutch pads here. Let me go ahead and do this one-handed. If you've ever taken one apart, you know that you will cannot do this by hand. It's a pain. So, but it was letting all these guys rub against the bell, which turned it red hot, got hotter and hotter and hotter, which got that spring weaker and weaker and weaker. But like I said, I was lucky enough to have another clutch here. Went ahead, pulled it apart, rebuilt the one that was on there. So you can see she got hot, some of the paint's off, but all the internals, all the little clutch discs and spring are all new. So go ahead and give it one more try. But like I said, the way the gear ratio is, we might end up, hopefully I don't smoke this one. I'm not gonna get on it like I did the, if it doesn't go, it doesn't go. I'll look into a torque converter setup. So go ahead and give this over to Seth. Fire this thing up again. And we'll just do a quick little lap around the yard, kind of see how it feels. But here we go.
Thank you.
Go ahead and start this thing again. It should idle right up. I gotta quit touching it. But it's not engaging. So you can see all the weight on the back there. It doesn't really want to turn without anybody in it.
right, we are back up here at the shop. Go ahead and shut this thing off. Now it did much better. Being able to actually get full throttle on the pedal allowed the clutches to engage a lot sooner. As you guys saw, it took off much better, much quicker. But I went down the yard, came around. I am gonna look in to see if I can get a bigger, a larger bottom sprocket for the axle. Maybe get one with less teeth on the clutch itself. That way it doesn't have to work so hard. But it did. I know if I'd have kept going, I was going to smoke that clutch as well. And I really don't want to do that. So I'll look into getting a different clutch with fewer teeth. And I'll get a larger sprocket for the axle to help with our gear ratio and for takeoff. So I did, however, accomplish what I wanted to, which was have this engine on this thing and somewhat running. That way Seth could see it when he got home. Like I said, I was kind of a surprise. I wanted to have this thing ready for him to take around the yard and ride. Also wanted to get Delilah on there as well, because last when we were at the track last time, she asked if we could build her a car. So that's going to be a lot of fun, and we got plenty of time to figure all that out. So anyways, like I said, I'm going to look into a different clutch, larger sprocket for our axle to help with the gear ratio and takeoff. Other than that, I'm done. So anyways, I'm gonna end this video right here. Hope you guys liked it. Hope you enjoyed. This thing's gonna be really fast once we get the gear ratio figured out with that little 440 on there. Like I said, it's 18 horse versus the 6.5 to 8 horse, whatever the other little 212 was. So definitely a lot of fun. I am going to also look into some kind of front hubs for this thing too, to try to add more brakes to this thing. So yeah, anyways, you guys, thanks for watching. Thanks for hanging out. Hope you enjoyed the video. Hit that subscribe button if you haven't already, and I'll catch you on the next one.